Welcome back to Pacamira Golden Retrom. I am Famika Vieras. Last time we did the hedge maze, and now we're in the dollhouse. Princess, I have a big favor to ask of you. You do? What is it, pumpkin? You see, princess, my tooth fell out this morning, and I really want to get a coin from the tooth fairy. So would you please put my tooth under my leaves? Me? Oh no, pumpkin. There's no way I'm going to touch your tooth. But princess, I just want that tooth fairy to pay me a visit. Quit it, pumpkin. I'm not touching your filthy tooth. That it's just a tooth, and besides, Mr. Pumpkin even asked you nicely and everything. Oh, is that so? Why don't you do it then? Gladly. Don't worry, Mr. Pumpkin, I'll do it for you. You will, really? Yes. Oh, look at me, I'm so polite and kind. It's still not inside my mouth, just reach for it. Alright then, say ah. Ah. Oh, look at me, I'm so much better than Fleta. Got it. Let me just put it under your leaves. And it's all done. Oh, thank you, miss. You're welcome, pumpkin. I hope you meet the tooth fairy tonight. Me too, thank you so much, miss. Are you two done yet? Yes. Don't waste my time, I wanna go play. Sorry, Fleta. I love sunbathing. The warm sunlight always welcomes me, always makes me feel at home. Tall, colorful stained glass windows stand graciously, casting ephemeral lights show all over the hall. I wasn't done talking! This is where I usually drink my tea with Egliette. Sounds wonderful. Why, thank you, miss. This is my Trump room. It's made especially for my favorite card games. You want to play with me? Oh, I... Hooray! Come on, let's sit down and play. I'm not done talking. Need me to explain the rules? Yes. All you need to do is flip the cards. It doesn't matter what you get. You will win as long as you flip them all. Sorry, Mr. Pumpkin. I'm not sure about what you're trying to say. What do you mean? Just flip them all over and be quick about it. You've got to catch them all. Oh, is this like memory? Alright. Let's start. I'll go first. I took a chance there, I wasn't sure. I'm actually pretty good with memory. I like the game memory. They won. Why isn't that great for you? You weren't even that good. I was just distracted. Just let you win because I was feeling sorry for you. Isn't that right, Agliette? I'm better at card games than Miss Smarty Pants here, aren't I? I thought so. What are you looking at me like that for? Come on, let's do something else. Follow me. Yes, Flatta. Hey, do you want to see my poker face? Sure, let's see it. Ready? Here I go. So, did you like it? Yes, Pumpkin, that's a nice expression you have there. Isn't it a nice day today, Miss Pumpkin? Why, yes it is, Mr. Pumpkin. Array of sweets laid out on the table. Just don't eat any of my favorites. Actually, try not to eat anything at all. Just drink the tea or something. What do you mean? Chubby girls always get married last, isn't that right, Agliette? That's mean. Come, let's sit. Fleta, can I ask you a question? Of course, what is it? Why are you always so mean to me? Have I done anything to upset you? No, not really. Why do you ask? I don't know, you're always in a bad mood, so I just thought... You're not very good at thinking, are you? Look, Agliette, I made her upset. She totally does. Flatta? What do you want? Can't you see I'm busy talking to Agliette? Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to. Didn't mean to? I didn't mean to upset you. Well, but you did. Didn't she, Agliette? I'm so sorry, Flatta. I don't know what I did, but I never meant to upset you. Then how about you prove it to me? How? Show me that thing you always carry around with you. My pocket mirror? Uh-huh. Show it to me and I'll forgive you. Why not? Fine, but you have to be really careful. It's really important to me. Why is it so important? I bet it's not even gold. It's not like it's that valuable. Shut up, Agliette. I am being careful, can't you see? So why is this toy so important to you? It's not a toy. It's not? Is it actually made of gold? I don't know what it's made of. Then what? How can you not know what it's made of? I just don't know, Fleta. Then why do you even carry it around everywhere? I'm not sure, it's just a really important thing to me. I feel like I always have to have it close to me. Maybe a bit like you and Agliette, you're always together, right? Don't you dare compare my Agliette to a toy. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to. Hey, are you listening to me? Don't just look at me like that. Are you stupid? Don't you dare compare Agliette to your stupid pocket mirror. Do you understand, or will I have to hit you and make you understand? Her eyes turned red. But Agliette, she was being mean. You know I never do that. Now shut up and you won't be getting dinner. Fine, but it's not because I feel sorry or anything. I, Fleta, am terribly sorry for what I just said. Please don't think badly of me, as I'm just a little girl. I just want to be your friend, so please accept my apologies. That's enough, Egliette. I'm sorry too, Fleta. I didn't mean to hurt your feelings. I accept your apology. Can we be friends again? Fine. Do you still want to play with me? Alright. Let's go. There are still a bunch of things I want to show you. I can't wait. Hey, miss. Can I ask you a question? What is it, Mr. Pumpkin? I heard you're going to lose to Fleta in every game you play. Is it true? I mean, there is an ending to do that, but that's not the ending I'm going for. Oh, Pumpkin, I'm flattered. I would do anything to receive Princess Fleta's good graces. I'm surprised Fleta lets me come back here. This is actually my most special room. Really? It's a magic room. I'll turn into anything you desire. All you have to do is ask. See, that's amazing. Let me show you. What color do you like best? I really like red. But I don't really like red. Never mind that. Just choose between pink and blue. Which do you like best? I like blue. But I think pink's better. I like pink better, so we're going with pink. Alright, now watch and learn. Good day. What would you like to see today, Princess? I would like to see a pink room. Very well, you may step aside inside. Let's go. Alright. This is my big library. It's where I keep all my favorite tales. There is not a single boring book in this whole room. It's impressive, Fleta. I don't feel like reading right now. I'll give you 10 minutes to check some books if you want to. Thank you, Fleta. Only 10? The Complete Biography of Queen Egliette by Princess Fleta. In other words, she wrote all these books. Once a little missy who was well known for being quite... All of her faithful butlers enjoyed serving her tea, obediently answering her every plea. Ruthless and powerful, the girl's last breaths were everything but colorful. Got what she deserved, embedded in aconite was her last dessert. With such a cruel demise, said the missy, it is now God's duty to strip me of my disguise. Having disposed of their queen, who had taken their voice, overwhelmed with freedom, did her servants rejoice. It's hard to believe Fleta would like this kind of story. How to Be a Perfect Princess by Princess Fleta. Fancy elegant white porcelain vase decorated with... Frilly Dresses and Pretty Countesses by Sir Pumpkin III. How to Dance the Waltz by Mr. Rabbit. A Boy's Midnight Journey by Henry J. certain boy was known to have a problematic condition, one that would only affect him during the night, one that even the best doctors could not explain. Thought to be the work of the devil by many, it was said that the boy would wake up during the night and speak to the ones that had perished. Despite the various attempts to cure him of his curse, the boy kept on being disturbed by strange voices during the night. Everything from this page on is scratched out. Something written on the inside of the back cover. No one around him will ever know about the secret of his. Such a privilege belongs only to me, my dear. This is the only thing written in the back. 1001 Riddles for Curious Minds by Lord Pumpkin Squash. Book about the boy disappeared. Can't find a book I'm looking for. Do you have any idea where it might be? What book are you talking about? It's a book about a boy who could talk to the dead. What? There's no way I would ever have such a horrible book in my library. But I found it just a while ago. Would you please stop telling lies, miss? It's not pleasant. But it's true, I'm not lying. Yes, you are. Are you finished yet? I don't want to stay here any longer. These are my three special mirrors. Special? Mm-hmm. There's the mirror of prayer, then there's the mirror of truth, and then the mirror of judgment. What do they do? They come with me. Just come with me. I'll show you. This is the mirror of judgment. It judges whoever stands in front of it. Sounds scary. It's not scary. It's fun. Watch, I'll do it first since you're such a scaredy cat. Oh, mirror, mirror on the wall. I command you tell me who's the fairest of them all. Certainly not you, princess. What? How am I not the fairest of them all? You told me I was just yesterday. Are you trying to pick a fight with me? We'll see about that. Come on, it's your turn to be judged. Oh no, I'm fine, Fleda. This is an order. Go and get judged by the mirror right this instant. Mirror, I would like to ask you who's the fairest of them all. There is only one who can hold that title, miss, and that one person is you. I know, Agliette. Me, but that's enough. Got what it deserved. Let's just go on to the next one. Alright. This is the mirror of truth. It will always answer all your questions with nothing but the truth. I see. I go first. Oh, mirror, mirror on the wall, tell me who's the pinkest of them all. That is you, princess. Haha, I knew it. It could have only been you, Fleda. Right? Now you go, it's your turn. Should I ask? I don't know, it's your turn, not mine. Why won't Agliette talk to me? What is my name? Why can't I remember my name? So three of them are name related. I kind of want to know this one. Is it not that Queen Agliette won't talk to you, miss? You simply cannot hear her. See, I told you. Isn't the mirror right, Agliette? See? Let's go to the next mirror. Come on. This is the mirror of prayer. It can make any wish come true. Really? Any wish? I accidentally pushed the button, sorry. Oh, mirror, mirror on the wall, please make my mouth taste like candy. Ew. Very well, princess. Your wish is my command. It worked. Now I can always taste my favorite candy. Can I really ask for anything? Of course, my mirrors can do anything. Then I want a pocket mirror. Huh? What would you want something like that for? You already have one. Your wish is my command. Thank you, mirror. I don't get it. Why did you wish for another pocket mirror? I got it for you, Fleda. Here, you can take it. What? You look like you really wanted one, so I got you this. Why would I want something stupid like that? Just get rid of it or something, will you? I don't want you littering my house. But I... Let's go. Follow me. Took you long enough. Don't ever make me wait like that, like this again. Sorry. Alright, I'm going to actually save, and this will just be a shorter episode. But yeah, we're making our way through the dollhouse, and next time probably, I don't know, maybe finish the dollhouse, we'll see. But thank you for watching, hopefully you enjoyed, and we will see you again next time.